Beyond, my name is Colin Moriarty. I'm IGN's senior editor in charge of our PlayStation coverage. You know who this is. This is Shuhei Yoshida, president of Sony's Worldwide Studios. Mr. Yoshida, thank you for joining us.
Beyond
to you, my friend. So with Vita, the big news for Vita last night was that you guys dropped the price. And you dropped the price in Japan a while ago, but you and I had talked about that, and that was really bringing it in Japan more to price parity with the West, right? So now this is like a bona fide price drop for the West. How important do you think this is going to be to getting more Vitas out there in the wild? Do you think the $50, $100 price drop, I guess, depending on the version you buy, is that going to really be meaningful, you think, for the consumer?
Yep, I think so. Yeah, you know, so when we talk about people who have not purchased PS Vita, you know, the price of the hardware and the, you know, games, you know, availability is number one, two, you know, reasons that, you know, so we kind of waited, you know, the February timing for the Japan price drop was, you know, time so that because we knew that many great games were coming out in Japan that time, you know, February, March time frame. So we wanted to, you know, provide both the, you know, contents, games and the, you know, price drop. And we looked at the, you know, games coming out now, you know, almost every week, you know, great indie games are coming. And we have, you know, Killzones or, you know, Tearaways and other games from South Park is coming, you know, for this holiday. So we thought this is the right time to do. And because, you know, PS Vita works very well with PS4, so I think it helps as we, you know, prepare for the launch of PS4 to get more PS Vita out there.
One of the things that people are, I think, a little troubled about with Vita going forward is it seems like there's a lack of big AAA games past Tearaway and Killzone that we don't, maybe they're in development, we just don't know about them yet. It seems to be kind of turning into a very indie-focused device, which is great for the core gamer, but maybe it's difficult for people to justify buying one without that big title. So you guys had mentioned that every studio is working on, all 14 studios you own are working on PS4 games. Are any of them, apart from Guerrilla and Media Molecule, which we already know are working on Killzone and Tearaway respectively, are they working on Vita games as well?
Yeah. So what we have made a statement about PS4 is, you know, actually all of our studios are working on some, you know, PS4 titles. But doesn't mean that they are all exclusively working on PS4 titles, you know, and many of them work on, you know, PS3 titles as well as, you know, PS Vita titles.
Can we expect more Vita announcements about next year at TGS or just in the, you know, kind of getting closer to the PS4's reveal? Or are you guys going to kind of let PS4 shine this fall and then worry about Vita?
Well,
after?
We don't talk about our future announcement before we do that.
That makes sense. So one of the things that you guys have focused on and really showed was, I guess, the remote play functionality. And you'd showed that actually at the PS4 reveal in February playing Knack. But we learned a little bit more about it since then, and we saw it again, I think, with Assassin's Creed, which was really cool, and it seemed to have worked. Are you guys really confident that this is going to work for all of these games? I know you said that in February. We talked about it after the PS4 reveal. This is really going to work when like right out the box for PS4 for all the games that don't use a PlayStation camera or whatever.
Yeah, that's the plan. Yeah, so, you know, we have not finished the development of the, you know, hardware or system software as yet. So, you know, we have to wait for the, you know, all the things get done. But the as far as the game's compatibility, you know, it just works. You know, the game developers, all they need to do is worry about the button, you know, reconfigurations, because the PS Vita has less number of buttons compared to the actual 4. Yeah, so that's the only thing, basically, that the developers have to do. So it's just a matter of us finishing the system software that I demonstrated yesterday, but it's not the final version. Still work to do. But as you know, demonstrated by Assassin's team, you know, it's already working, and it works, you know, brilliantly. You know, I was playing the Assassin's Creed in the backstage, and you know, PS4 displays both the large TV and the PS Vita remote play, and I was looking at the both screens, and it's almost exactly the same time. So, you know, felt no lag at all. So it works pretty, pretty well.
Awesome. And I did notice, and I'm glad you kind of brought it up in terms of when they were playing AC4 on the stage. I did see them use touch controls for AC4 on PS4. So do developers have to approach this when they're making a PS4 game? Is this something that they really have to think about for every game, about how it might interact with Vita? Or is there a way for it to just stream to Vita without them really playing with it much in the course of development?
So there are a few ways to support Vita, but the initial approach we are taking is to interpret the Vita control as DualShock 4 control. So from the PS4 game development standpoint, they are just making PS4 games. And the game knows if it's connected to PS Vita or DualShock 4. So game just adjusts the remaps the control depending on the devices. So that's all that game has to do. So all they have to do is to use the PS Vita like another controller and make sure that it works well for that game.
Fair enough. And it seems like you guys are kind of emphasizing Vita more than ever now in terms of its interactivity with PS4. And we often kind of speculate that maybe the two will go together in a bundle. And we've noted that you haven't really talked about many other SKUs other than the base cameraless $400 SKU for PS4. Will you guys put PS4 and Vita together officially in a bundle, or is that something you're just going to let the retailers take care of?
Well, there are lots of rumors, and you are suspecting who was the source of that rumor. And so it was
oh,
not
you saw
us.
My, you saw my tweet.
Yes, yes. Yeah, it was not us. It right. was your speculation becomes the someone in the know. So it's all that thing that happens on the internet all the time.
So you guys have no plans right now for
that, there's no plans to talk about. But the bundles are very easy to create.
Right.
Yeah. So all our regions, SC Europe or SC America, comes up with all kinds of bundles all the time. So never say never.
Okay.